Hey everybody, and welcome to Let's Play The Adventures of Shugy. I am Lei, aka the Obi-Link, and today we're gonna see what this game is all about. Let's just jump right on into it. Following the directions in his grandfather's will, Shugy heads to the castle he inherited. Let's hope it's not Luigi's Mansion type deal here.
Is this the right place? According to the will, it definitely is. What? It says this place is haunted.
Yeah, we're getting Luigi's Mansion territory here.
Ghosts and ghouls won't stop me.
There's only one way to find out what's going on. Dot. What is all this steam about? Oh no, steam! Get the steam away from me! Oh no!
You know, I wonder if that's a shout out to steam, like, the thing that I'm playing this on. That would be a very pandering way to get this on to Steam. Oh goodness.
Blimey, it's hot in here.
So take off that hood.
So take off all that hood.
Shugy thinks he may have found the problem. Dun dun dun.
Welcome to Shugy.
Move him with this. Pull the instructions back up with the select button.
Press the A button to jump. The action button is a trigger. That's very weird.
Press the jump, the longer you hold, the higher you jump. Let's head right on into this. I like the overworld already. I'm tired of games that feel like they don't have to have an actual overworld. It looks like this one actually does. Look, these platform ones, I like them. They're so cute. You can just go around here and go to the different rooms, and it looks like we'll be visiting three, unless there's some secret ones to show up, and there's a gallery here. So, four, technically. But I just love the fact that these have these actual rooms. It makes me so mad with platform games now, like the recent new Super Mario Bros. Games, even some of them that do pretend to have an overworld. They're literally just ways to get to levels. Like Rayman Origins, it pretends to have an overworld, but it's just a little map that has the levels on it. It doesn't really have anything special about it, which means I don't like it, because there's nothing there. There's no point to it. Okay, why is this not letting me go into anything? Maybe I spoke too soon about liking the overworld. This won't let me do anything. But while I'm trying to figure out where to go, hi y'all, how you doing? Long time no play. Whoa. Oh, in a spin. Spin to your heart's content and reach. Okay, skip that. Okay. Ooh, you can rotate. Spin to your heart's content to reach all the gems. Oh, and if you haven't figured it out already, I have not played this game yet. I got it. I mean, I saw it for a while on Steam. I was like, it looks okay. I'm not sure if I like it. But they recently put it in the not the Humble Indie Bundle, but the other one, Indie Royale. So I decided, I'll pick it up. This one looked the most interesting to me. There are some others I may do from that bundle, but this is the one that got me to get it for about $5, whatever it was. They're always good deals, the indie bundles. And right now, Humble Indie Bundle 6 is going on, which has a game I can't wait to start playing, which I'll probably blind play for this also, called Dust Force. I love the look of that game. It looks so fun. Basically, for those who don't know, you play as a little duster guy.
Shugy has been caught in a time slip. Once the clock in the corner has gone round, you'll travel back in time and encounter a past version of yourself. Colliding with a past version will kill you, so be sure to stay away.
Some interesting twists. There. Okay, so.
Enemies kill you too! No way!
You can ground pound with that. But it's a game called Dust Force, and in it you play as a little duster guy. And it just looks like... It looks like a mix of N Plus and Super Meat Boy. Like N Plus, but really challenging. And that's just so incredibly cool to me. And okay, so you have to get a pass version of yourself by doing that. Okay. Let's do one more to stand there for a tiny bit. And it just looks really hard, and I wanted it since I first heard about it, and it finally got into a bundle, so I was able to get it for like $5 maybe. It was a good price. All of them are good prices. Always get the bundles. Even if you don't like any of the games, it's worth it just to play them for the tiny bit of money that they're asking for, and to support indie developers. Play them. They're amazing. But to actually focus on the game, it's a pretty decent platformer so far. Not hard yet. It's only hard because I fail at life. Just fail at it. It's only hard because of that. But it's a pretty fun little game. Not bad in the slightest. Shuggy's a cute little... Shuggy, I guess. What is he? Is he a vampire bat? That's what the voice I was using, but what exactly is a Shugy? Is he, and does he wear Snuggies? That is the question. So these are basically swamps, essentially. I like that they don't go just straight up, they have to like fly themselves up. But speaking of this being so much like Luigi's Mansion, I am incredibly excited for Luigi's Mansion 2, or Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon. Okay, this is interesting. Okay. Looks like what I have to do is drag it to me. Oh joy. The response time on this. Oh, okay. Notes to the wise. The direction Shugy is facing is the direction your thing... is the direction you turn the world. That is... very nice to know. Now, after just spamming the button the whole time. And there we go. Key found! Now, this is a blind playthrough, so I don't know if there are, like, I'm missing, like, tons of secrets. But after I play through these, I'll go back and make sure. Looks like I might be missing, time. Okay, not sure what I'm supposed to be doing here. Oh, okay, I see. I have to get all of these. Yeah, okay, get that there. Avoid the scary monsters, or the not really at all scary monsters, the incredibly adorable monsters, and... okay, I see. You dastardly little game, you. Making me go all over this level here. Oh, See, this is an easy game, and I just fail at games. I don't know why I'm a let's player, because I'm so bad at games. This is why I've been gone for a year. This is why. You don't want me back. You don't want me back. But back to Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon, it looks... I'm not going to say an improvement on the original, but more like an extension. I hope it's not just a level extension like all these new Super Mario Bros. Games have been. Crappy level extensions. Or not crappy, I guess. Mediocre is the word. They just don't have anything going for them. I hope it has a lot of new stuff. It has three mansions, apparently. Or at least that's what I've been told. That it has three. I believe they said that back at the first E3. It was announced at the 2011 E3. So they very well may have changed that. So there may be more. They may have combined them. I don't think it'll be less than three, but it may be more. Most likely not, but I do hope it's good and has a lot of freshness to it. I'm worried that they're just going to retread the GameCube game, because that's what Nintendo's been doing a lot recently. I love you, Big N, but stop retreading. Do new stuff. We love the groundwork you set. You've set amazing groundwork. But because you have set such amazing groundwork, you have tons of room to experiment, and you're not doing that. Which is why your games just aren't very good anymore. Okay, let's see. These have in here, they have leaderboard scores. On some of them, they have things on the right, if you see there, like that one's empty, but on some of them, in the right little bulb, they have something, so I don't know if that is a thing I need to care about, but if it is, I will go back. It looks like it might just be something that it just does automatically, so I might not have to worry about it. Just telling you like what happens in the level. Those are launch bobs you can see are shmoo. They're stuck to the wall and will happily roll around forever. However, they do get spooked easily and will jump if you run into them. Guide them into the cages and release the gems. Okay. Guide them into the cages to release the gems. Oh joy. Here come the tedious elements, it seems. Let's hope this isn't too tedious. Okay, so I'm supposed to guide them to the cages. Yeah, it feels like they couldn't do time runs because of these things, honestly. Feels like these would be way too tedious for them to do a time run with. See how many it takes. Okay, just one each. Not as bad then. But still, doing things like this in a platformer, I don't want to do things like this in a platformer. That's just it. Like, game designers, listen up. In a platformer, a big chunk of the thing people tend to like is the speed. And in things like this, there's no speed. Because you're just having to go back and forth, and it's just not that fun. I mean, this isn't bad. Don't get me wrong. It's not awful or anything. It's just, it feels like a waste of time. It feels like there should be a different way to unlock these cages. Like the button presses earlier. Those were great. Those were perfect. I mean, sometimes they'll get a little tedious, sure. But overall, they're great things because it all depends on your speed. On things like the big problem with these is that you have to wait for them. You have to wait for them to roll on by. And if they all came really fast, it wouldn't be a problem, but they don't. And they never do in any game. These are good for puzzle games. These aren't good for platformers. And there is my game design soapbox. Yay! See, I'm just gonna have to stand here and wait. Wait for that one to come. And that is... Oh! Whoa! Ignore my last rant. Ignore it. I feel stupid. Okay, let's... Not sure how much... This isn't taking long. Let's see if we can do two more. Let's do two more, and then we'll call this an episode. I'm just hoping that this new recording software that I'm using is decent. What I'm doing is I'm not using recording software to record my voice and my screen. I'm using separate ones. I'm using an external mic, so I'm hoping it all sounds good, because I can't really monitor it like I can with the video software I'm using. But that's not a big deal. It should turn out fine. I want to see what that green thing is, though. Oh, dang it. That's cool. I look up top and it has the previous level counter. I could do this one faster, definitely. Does that mean that this is the only... I have no clue what that means. Is it just supposed to make the game harder? Or... I have no clue what the green thing does, but it turned me. Oh, okay. I guess maybe that's how you're technically supposed to get those two? But you can get them fine the other way? It is weird. That's pointless game design. But this will be the last level of this episode. We'll do one more because I was short. Do this. I'll walk the line. Oh, that's neato schmido. Oh, these controls are officially complicated. Joy. Joy of joys, light of my life, complicated controls. For those who obviously, everyone who can't see my controller right now, I'm having to press up to go, yeah, it's gravity. I'm having to press up to go what looks like up on the screen, even though it should be left or right that I have to press. That's annoying. Looks like this game relies a lot on gimmicks. I'm not sure if that's usually not a good thing. We'll see by the end of it. Should at least be a fun enough time. Dang it. But I mean, it's a great looking game, definitely. I mean, it's not groundbreaking, but not all games have to be. Good. And key found. But I think that I will call it for an episode. I am hoping that everything goes right and I can get this up. Because I missed you guys and I hope you missed me too. But that is the adventures of Shugy. And I promise next time I will be funnier. I will be. But until then, see you next time!